In this video lecture, we are going to see the explanation related to RNA polymerases. There is some small difference existing there between the polymerases of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In prokaryote, it's only a single RNA polymerase that performs the transcription, whereas some three different types of RNA polymerase are existing there in the eukaryotic organisms. The prokaryotic RNA polymerases are large RNA polymerase that have been present there in the E. coli cells. It's also referred as DNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme. They are generally coded by RPO genes. It has various subunits, that is two alpha subunits, one beta and one beta dash, one omega and a sigma subunit. These subunits interacts to form an active complete enzyme called as a holoenzyme. So, it is divided into two forms, that is core enzyme and then holoenzyme. If you look at into the core enzyme, it will be having the two subunits of alpha, one beta dash subunit as well as an omega subunit. All these together forms into the core enzyme as it has been shown there in the right hand side. With that, when a sigma unit is uniting, it forms into a holoenzyme, which is performing the role of transcription. So here the functions of various subunits were also noted there in the inside image. That is, alpha subunit is coded by which gene? What is its function? Like that, what is a beta and what is a beta dash? That is beta prime unit and a sigma. So sigma is the one which is playing an important role in the promoter binding. That is, binding to the promoter could be enhanced or it is carried out only with the help of sigma factor. Further, we discuss some peculiar property of this enzyme. This core enzyme can able to elongate the synthesis. However, it cannot able to initiate the RNA synthesis. So, for initiation of the transcription factor, sigma subunit are playing a major role. That is, they are involved in the recognition of the promoter. Say, for example, a common sigma factor is a sigma 70, which is playing a major role there in the E. coli cells as a promoter binding sigma factor, which we have already seen under the topic of the promoter. It increases its affinity of core enzyme, that is other subunits of the enzyme, to bind into the promoter, and it decreases the affinity for non-specific DNA binding sites. There are various kind of sigma factors based upon the growth condition. They are all listed there. That is sigma 19, sigma 24. In the bracket, the gene that codes for the sigma factor is also given. And the next one refers to the function of that particular sigma factor. Say, for example, sigma 28 is the one which is coded by RPOF, and it is a sigma factor that is required for flagella synthesis gene getting expressed. So like that, various kinds of sigma factors were present there in the natural system. In E. coli, RNA polymerase can synthesize RNA at a rate of around 40 nucleotide per second at 35 degrees centigrade, and it require magnesium ion for its activity. So these are all the other things that are required for the successful functioning of the RNA polymerase. So, RNA polymerase encoded by bacteriophages such as T3 and T17 are single polypeptide chains which are smaller than that of the bacterial subunit enzymes. So, these are all the other types of RNA polymerase that have been present there in the living systems. This bacteriophage based RNA polymerase can rapidly synthesize the RNA, that is 200 nucleotides can be added per second at 37 degree centigrade, compared to that of only 40 nucleotide can be added by an E. coli RNA polymerase. E. coli RNA polymerase also has an absolute requirement for divalent metal cations such as magnesium, manganese and cobalt. So the last property that they are discussing is related to sensitivity towards the antibiotic. For example, rifamycin, streptovaricins, streptogliding and sulfhydryl reagents are those that can able to inhibit the RNA polymerase of the E. coli cell. Next, we look at the eukaryotic RNA polymerase. They are similar to prokaryotic ones. However, there are three forms of RNA polymerase seems to exist there in the eukaryotic organism. They are large number of complex enzyme system that are required for transcription of different types of eukaryotic genes. They require a lot of protein transcriptional factors for their activation. Those transcriptional factors only we have seen there in the previous lecture. If you look at into this diagram, you are able to see a lot of different transcriptional factors that are required for eukaryotic transcription to be initiated. This eukaryotic RNA polymerases can be differentiated based on the chromatographic purification of these enzymes at different salt concentration and based on another factor of sensitivity towards the fungal toxin, that is alpha amanitin. So based on these two factors, three different kind of RNA polymerase activity could be recognized. The first polymerase, that is RNA polymerase 1, transcribe most of the rRNA genes and it is located there in the nucleoli and is insensitive for the alpha amanitin. Polymerase 2 is referred as an important polymerase of the eukaryotic system since it is associated with the transcription of most of the protein coding genes in an organism. Apart from that, it also transcribes the small nuclear RNA genes. This polymerase is located in the nucleoplasm. Compared to polymerase 1, this one is very sensitive for alpha amanitin. The third polymerase transcribes the genes for transfer RNA, 5S rRNA and other certain small rRNA molecules. It is located there in the nucleoplasm and it is moderately sensitive to alpha amanitin. The last group of RNA polymerase what we are going to see is RNA dependent RNA polymerases. These are commonly encoded by RNA viruses, mainly to synthesize RNA by using their genetic material, that is RNA as a template. Viral RNA dependent RNA polymerases are responsible for replicating the genome and for synthesizing the mRNA by using minor strand of the RNA template. That is, their genetic makeup itself is made up of RNA. In order to replicate that particular genetic material or to transcribe that particular genetic material, they need RNA dependent RNA polymerase type of enzymes. So based on that only, they will be using two terms. One is replicase and another one is transcriptase for this RNA polymerases. That is, when they are engaged in a process of replication, it is referred as a replicase. Whereas when it functions for transcription of host rRNA by using the minor strand of RNA as a template, it is referred as a transcriptase enzyme.